Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. This is a challenge question. If A, B, C, D, E are real numbers, and A plus B plus C plus D plus E equals 8, A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus D squared plus E squared equals 16. What is the maximum value of E? We are going to use two different methods to solve this question. The first method, using Cauchy-Schwartz inequality. This is a very important inequality in mathematics. For any vectors u and v, the inner product of u and v squared is less than or equal to the inner product of u and u times the inner product of v and v. Here, this symbol means the inner product. From the first given condition, we have A plus B plus C plus D equals 8 minus E. If we square both sides, we have A plus B plus C plus D squared equals 8 minus E squared. From the second given condition, we have A squared plus B squared plus C squared plus D squared equals 16 minus E squared. What are we doing here? We are going to apply the Cauchy-Schwartz inequality. How to apply? That's a key point. We define u equals the column vector 1, 1, 1, 1. And v equals the column vector a, b, c, d. The inner product of u and v squared, by definition, equals 1 times a plus 1 times b plus 1 times c plus 1 times d, then squared. Simplify, we have a plus b plus c plus d squared. What is a plus b plus c plus d squared? It is 8 minus e squared. We have the first result. The inner product of u and u times the inner product of v and v equals 1 times 1 plus 1 times 1 plus 1 times 1 plus 1 times 1. This is the first part, the inner product of u and u. The inner product of v and v equals a times a plus b times b plus c times c plus d times d. Simplify, we have the first part is 4. The second part is a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared. The second part we have here, which is 4 times 16 minus e squared. We have two results. Based on the Cauchy-Schwartz inequality, we replace both sides by the two results. We have 8 minus e squared less than or equal to 4 times 16 minus e squared. This implies 4 times 16 minus e squared minus a minus e then squared is bigger than or equal to 0. Continue to simplify the left-hand side of this inequality. We have this. Continue to simplify. We have negative 5e squared plus 16e is bigger than or equal to 0. Factoring the left-hand side, we have e times 16 minus 5e is bigger than or equal to 0. How to solve this inequality? Set the left-hand side equal 0. This implies e equals 0, e equals 16 over 5. We have the two critical points. We use the two critical points to cut the whole x-axis into 3 sub-intervals. From negative infinity to 0, if e is inside of this interval, e is negative. 16 minus 5e is positive. Positive, negative, the product is negative. This is not the answer. In this interval, from 0 to 16 over 5, if e is inside, e is positive, 16 minus 5e is also positive. Positive times positive is positive, or at least is 0, non-negative. This is the solution. We still need to check if the last interval is also a solution. If e is in this interval, from 16 over 5 to positive infinity, inside of this interval, e is positive. 16 minus 5e is negative. Negative times positive is negative. Therefore, we only have this answer. E is in between 0 and 16 over 5. The question is, what is the maximum value of E? From this inequality, we have the maximum value of E is 16 over 5. We have done the first method. Method 2. Without using the Cauchy-Schwartz inequality. From the first given condition we have, a plus b plus c plus d equals 8 minus e. We square both sides. We have a plus b plus c plus d squared equals 8 minus e squared. This is the first result. From the second given condition we have, a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared equals 16 minus e squared. Both sides times 4. 4 times a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared equals 4 times 16 minus e squared. From this result, minus the first result. We have 4 times a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus d squared minus a plus b plus c plus d squared. The right-hand side is 4 times 16 minus e squared. Then minus 8 minus e squared. Simplify the left-hand side. Use complete square method. We can see the left-hand side equals a plus b squared plus a minus c squared. Here's a minus b squared plus a minus c squared. A minus d squared. B minus c squared. B minus d squared. C minus d squared. Equals the right-hand side. What can we see from the left-hand side? Left-hand side is a sum of squares. Any square cannot be negative. This implies the left-hand side cannot be negative because the left-hand side equals the right-hand side. This also implies the right-hand side cannot be negative. This means the right-hand side is bigger than or equal to zero. Simplify the left-hand side of this inequality. We also have the same inequality we see in method 1. From method 1, we know how to solve this inequality. This implies e is in between 0 and 16 over 5. The final answer is the maximum value of e equals 16 over 5. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.